So I remember I was in fourth grade, and that song was out by Queen. And Ronald Reagan had won the White House. And I was so, so excited. And I was like, take that, Jimmy Carter. Take that, Jimmy. I was little Sweet Bobby, right? Fourth grade, Sweet Bobby going, take that. Wait a minute, was it fourth grade? Let's see, 1980. Yeah, that was, well, I was 10 years old. That's about fourth grade. And I was like, take that, Jimmy Carter. Jimmy Carter bit the dust. Yeah. Anyway, I loved Reagan. Reagan was, man, I was an 80s kid, and Reagan was my stuff. All right, Matt, you missed Queen, man. What are you doing coming in here so late? Huh? Missing all the time I talk to us. Hey, Ken. Hey, Rick.
Phone's working out. And then I probably
it's garbage that way.
All right, let's see if it's better.
Oh, that's perfect. Thank you.
One setting. I didn't know what the new setting would do. Apparently, setting sucks. So thank you, Rick, for letting me know that. I'll ever have a great video.
Where do you want me? Yeah, okay. Try this again.
Advisor.
Yeah, don't.
Hey, I know. Listen, I'm in that same boat with you. Like, I don't know. Dakota, I said, if I turn green and get in the fetal position shower and she catches me in there, part of that, man, that hurts. Woo, I never had so. But we won't get on the soapboxes today. All right, so, and then it works. Right? So when you say, I don't know what it is. Huh? Like, let me give me a hug, okay? Got to hug my baby. Baby. Can you wear that? Yeah, I'll wear that when I get done. Go put it down there and we'll play dress up. Okay. All right. So we're working. Click the ETLs because sometimes I forget. Is it XOM that gives me 1256 for oil or is it USO? And I forget that, right? So I'm like, I'll probably trade in XOM. And then I'm like, wait a minute, which I got to look up. Which one's my 1256 contract? So here's my 1256 ETLs that I trade. Now, one thing that you and I need to make it on big, 2.57% today would be a good day probably to enter into a gold trade. What about silver? Here's the facility index. And so gold selling silver over silver. Increased volatility as a percentage is great today. The energy position in volatility is down. Right? Not the day. I'm doing this on an uptick in volatility. Out on the VIX, 1.84%. Check this there. Share. I'll post that in the room. Tax. Just get me 1256. I share it all. So start with 40. Y'all, what's wrong with this? All crud ball, crud ball. Get back up there. Here we go. Today is the 17th, and it is St. Patrick's Day. Can we still celebrate St. Patrick's Day, or is that a racist holiday? Can we still do that one? Hopefully we can. Because my kids were all excited about going to go pinching people that didn't have on green today. All right, so what is the netlick for today? Well, let's see. Netlick is, man, you're not recognizing my face, Thinkorswim? I hate the face. I'd rather have the thumb. Because when I'm at night and you got the CPAP mask on, it doesn't recognize your face. So we are at, let's see here. We are at 51,402.84, which means we are up $401.76.
We are the champions, my friends. And we'll keep on fighting till the end.
All right, so that's it's a good day. All right, so we've been having quite a few good days, y'all. I mean, I never want to get in the brag category, right? We never want to say, ooh. I mean, we've taken some hits, haven't we? You know, we were down 979 this, up 8, up 1, down 9, up 5, down 106. But we're up. But I don't look at this too much. Remember, Nick Saban yesterday. Nick Saban, he's not watching that scoreboard. This is our scoreboard, y'all. Which way the market's gone, doesn't it? If my deltas went from 84 to 28, what happened? Anybody know? I can tell that the market has gone down, right? Because when it goes down, it's an inverse relationship with delta. And this is so important, guys, that y'all got to know this. So market goes down, right? Deltas go up. It's just the way it happens. So market goes up, deltas go down. It's an inverse relationship. So I don't even need to look at the market. All I got to do is look at my deltas to tell me the story of what happened. Right? All right. So what is my sweet, sweet theta? Y'all, I may have to play some more music because this is going to look good. I've been looked. Let's see. Where you at? Think or swim. Where'd you go, baby? Hold on a minute. Oh, no wonder. Gotta close that. Six. Check it at 306.67 in the sweet, sweet theta. I mean, how do I not play the Jeffersons, y'all? I mean, I can't go a day without playing him. And we still got positive Vega. Y'all, look, we got between 0.10 and 0. So looking, I'll see what. So 17,156. But as a comparison to net lick, that should go down. So now, okay, between 20 and 30 is 35% max. I'm at 33%. So I'm looking good. I'm looking good. So my spreadsheet should be fine with me. If you're going by Tasty Trade, you got no adjustment. I wrote the code that says if you have positive Vega, you need no adjustment. And finally, after we were rebels the last few days here, needing delta adjustments, now it says we're delta neutral. No adjustment necessary. So this is beautiful. So the forest, our theta forest, is in good shape. So this thing should say we're going to be selling premium today. And it says we'll be selling the 15%, okay? So if when I die and go to glory, Beth's just going to come in here and sell a 15 delta strangle, and she's going to do it at 10:30, 12:30, and 2:30. But since I'm not dead yet, I'm more actively managing the account. Now, you follow this, certainly, right? You're going to be fine. So the spreadsheet says I need to sell $592 in premium today. Oil went down, so it's not doing bad. Filled in yesterday. Trying to make sure I keep in line which everything is here. Let's see. Up again, like I like it. I'm not sick at it, but I'm hiring today, don't we? So I think no management necessary. We do have one trade to put on in the SPX today. And I really like the day. Go ball to the recess one time in live action. And that's why we go through this each and every day and we do the same stuff. So we'll come back and we'll see about putting that trade on. So we got two campaigns going on here. We got the Rick trade, Monday, Wednesday, Friday. And then we got the Cameron Skinner trade, which we put one on every day and we take one off every day. When do I do it? I'm going to take these things off when they've been in here for 30 days. So we still got 18 days, y'all, before our campaign starts kicking. And that's when we're going to start seeing this bump up, right? Our projected yearly profit, our yearly return, all of this stuff is really starting to kick into gear once this campaign is finally in gear. And you hadn't seen it in gear yet, right? You have not seen that yet. Sorry, y'all, I'm drawn to this. Why is that doing that? That's killing me. Hold on, let me see if I can fix it right quick like. Yeah, there we go. All right, so this is where we're about to really start making money. We are about to kick this thing into gear, and we're about to start making a little bit of bling, bling, bling. All right, so let's go to our equities tab. Now, keep in mind, the thing that kills most traders is, I can't find any trades, man. What am I going to trade? Let me go to Wall Street Bets, man. And you're going to look at you and go, can you elaborate a little further on that? And you go, yeah, what are you going to do to reduce my cost basis? And 99.9% of your financial advisors out there who are managing your money are going to tell you, I don't know. They don't know. Or they'll make up something because they don't know what it means to reduce cost basis. So that used to be, and I said, what is he talking about? And y'all, it probably took me 4 years of listening to Tom Shoshnoff and Tasty Trade before I go, oh, now it makes sense. Reduce cost basis. Yeah. I got you. Was someone going to say something? Reducing cost basis, y'all, is the stuff. right? Reducing cost basis is what this is entirely about. And if y'all ever get that, so in other words, if I want to buy something for a dollar, let me reduce that down to 90 cents, my cost. Well, how can I do it? Well, in the real world, maybe it's a little hard to do, right? But in options and trading, man, it's all we do, reduce cost basis. If I buy something, you dang right, I'm going to sell something against it to reduce that cost basis. That's exactly what we're doing with DraftKings. Isn't it cool that, I mean, I'm not maybe not getting them entirely for free, but I will. You watch this. The 100 shares that I'm going to get in DraftKings will be mine. All mine! And they'll all be on for free at some point because I'm going to sell some calls against it. And I'm going to sell premium against it. And if my calls get, you know, taken away from me, then I'm going to sell me some puts. And we're going to make us some money in that thing. So, and you can do it with more DraftKings, right? You can go Apple, you can do it, all kinds of stuff. But that's a great little wheel strategy there, using the proceeds to buy additional shares. Diamond is a hedge, right? Which is doing really, really well on the short that I've sold that expires on Friday. Friday's going to be our payday, y'all. We're going to close some of these here. And if we closed them right now, let's say if we just took our payday today, $200, $300, $400, $500, $600 that we're making. But we've got this one going against us. So now we're down to 500. So now we're going to take out $460 is what we're going to make on Friday. Isn't that beautiful? Isn't that gorgeous? How much profits have we already taken? We've already taken 170. So you add another 500 to it. We've checked credit spreads. That's the way that I do and just focus on this. Look at this, y'all. P&O micros trades, aren't we? So what we're going to do? So we're going to profit until you put the closing date on it.
I wouldn't use that big spreadsheet, man. It takes up.
Hey, that's fine. It works for me. It may not work for y'all, but it works for me. So we exit that. We book the profit. And my favorite thing in the world, other than booking profits, is making this thing entirely green. All right. So I'll go. We'll do that. We'll do 50% profit close. Then let's see if I can scroll out a little bit so we can make the whole thing green. Take that. Go all the way across. Oh, man, come on. No, don't do that. Just go all the way across. There we go. And make her green, baby. Make her green. All right. There we go. So remember, we're not looking at the scoreboard so much, are we? We're looking at the plays. And guess what? This was a pass from Sweet Bobby to a put way down here. Shapunk, touchdown, Alabama! And I just recorded that onto my scoreboard. And I ain't even watching the scoreboard. But we knowing that, hey, you know, we completed our pass. AJ McCarron completed the pass. All right. So here we go. Julio for the touchdown. So here we go. Now we go, what am I doing? Oh, we'll see if weekly premium, make sure we got credit for our close. Look at there, y'all. Now we're up to $252. So we make $1,200, we make $1,500, right? Right? I have my spreadsheet, and part of my trades do have something like millions of Americans because you want to save a wildebeest or whatever. Some need is that. We'll trade in because we want to, you know, put the buys in here. Uncle Joe and Aunt Nancy, how much did he get? He got me bull. And there's some people trading. What you and I are going to do, Ken, Dimitri, Drew, Matt, Rick, is we're going to go in and we're going to take their money. Right? You and I are going to go in and we're going to take money from those who know not what they do. Forgive them, Lord. Right? And we're going to take money or tendies from them. So let them buy all the little options that they want to, let them buy all the little shares that they want to, and you and I are going to reduce cost basis, and we're going to slowly, methodically, but surely pull money out of their pockets and put it into ours because we are greedy capitalists and dang proud of it. And we're not cocky, we're confident, right? Because we got a plan. They ain't got a plan. Guess what they're doing, y'all? You're sitting here and you spend an hour with me every day watching me do the same thing over and over and over and over and over. And it may bore you to death. I hope it don't. I hope we have a good time together. But guess what we've got? We've got a plan, a well thought out, multi-year plan that was developed in a very comprehensive spreadsheet to pull money from someone else and give it to ourselves. And it's beautiful. Now, what they're doing today is they're going, I'm going to read Wall Street Bets before I read the Wall Street Journal. I'm going to go see what tendies they're talking about and what we're diamond hands on today. That's right. The drug dealer's always looking for the fix. Well, not the drug dealer, the druggie, right? The person who can't fuck him. Now, that's not to say that I'm not going to have to take out $4,000 from this. In this month, Casey Stimi, I love that, retired, living the life, man. Just, but you can one day, you know, buy that. Yesterday, and I had the salad bar, the garden bar. I, you know, knew, and I was so happy to see them. I didn't want to see the waitress. I didn't want to see the servers. I didn't want to see the welcome crew. I just want to get in and get out. And I did want to tip them big because I know, you know, people ain't going out to eat stuff and Ruby Tuesday is in bankruptcy. So I wanted to make sure I try to keep that little business going too, right? As much as I can, but going to the garden bar. So, you know, we spend, you know, $100 or whatever with a family of seven. My mama went with me, but Devin stayed at home. So we had seven. So we do our part, but you got to be putting money, Matt, you got to be growing this thing. I know that the wife wants whatever with the Stimi money. Let's do this too, but let's put some of the Stimi into the trading account because I believe we can grow this thing. And when you start believing, you'll be committed to it. Now, the deal is, it's hard to believe, isn't it? It really is hard to believe because you have been seeing so many shysters and so many people out there who talk loud and scream at you, hey, son, up here, we made $10,000 in 3 minutes. And you listen to, but that's not what I'm here for, right? That's not what I'm here to do. This. I like y'all, and I want to, I've seen people trading zero. I don't want you close. So we're in. All that difficult to get them, but call them and say, listen, Tasty Works, here's what you do. You go, Tasty Works is really wanting me to come over. They're going to give me 10 shares of stock if I come up from Thinkorswim. And can y'all give me a better rate on my thing? And the first thing they're going to do, well, what rate do you want? So you better make sure that you go, I know what rate that I want. You have something in mind, right? Don't just say, oh, I don't care. What can you get me? Tell them what you want, right? You've got access to my spreadsheet. You know what my commission rates are. I have hid nothing. My commission rates are, go to the variables page and I put them in. What are my commission rates? I need to see. It's been about a month or two before I begged them to change them and I don't think they have. Go to the variables tab. Go, it's in here somewhere. Break evens. It's embarrassing how big a spreadsheet is. I apologize. Where's that? Variables. So we'll say, well, I know this guy by the name of Bobby. He's a slob and the worst trader on the planet. And my God, his spam cap he wears every day. Looks like he's been, you know, in the hog pen for an hour or two. He's two on me. Down to pay for me. I pay $1, commissions, the whole nine yards, right? Exchange fees for my micros, I'm at $1.47. VIX, they charge me 85 cents, and on individual stocks, puts are. So say, well, this is converted on what we're talking about. So this is a law. Calculated, very boring, and build our accounts, right? That's what it all starts. I don't want you to make those same mistakes that I made coming up. All right. Now, with that said, we know we need to do a micro trade today. Well, how do we do? Well, we've got negative deltas. We say we don't need any delta adjustments. We've got good theta. Our vega is perfect. So we look here. Then we go to our micros. Doggone it, y'all, if we ain't just about delta neutral, which is where we want to be. Delta neutral here, negative deltas here. So we're looking good. So there's no need for me to sell a call. I hate calls, right? Hate them, hate them, hate them, hate them, hate them. but I love selling puts. So let's go sell our put in the micros. Your action tab tells you everything you need to know. So we go to the trade, not the trade group, we'll go to the options chain. Where we're going to go, like a broken record, we're going to go close to 60 days without going over. Which one is that? It's 44 days. So we'll go into the options chain. You could either go by Delta or you can do what the Schwab does, go probability being in the money. The only thing I use Delta on is VIX, right? I like having it here just to compare. But I go probability in the money. I'm going to go 15% probability, and we're going to sell one. And look, this old dog even learns tricks that I forget sometimes. So I need to right-click on this first, right, and copy the option. Because if I don't, as soon as I do this, Tastyworks is going to have a bug in the system. It's going to take me down to about 20 or 19 days out. Watch this. Here we go. So let's sell the 3580. You know what I'm going to say immediately. Boy, wouldn't it be nice to get more than 25.25? Dang it, do you think we could get 25.50? Because we're greedy. So then we're going to hit the send button, and we're going to hit fails, and it did. So Bobby didn't gripe, grumble, complain about that working. And then look, sure enough, it takes me down to the 15 days to expiration. Why it does that, I have no idea. So then we go to the spreadsheet, you know, like a broken record. And we do the same thing again and again. And ain't it great? Oh, man, hey, boring it may be, but gosh, y'all, is it going to make you into a whale of a trader? Much better than me. I am slow to catch on. It took me getting a leg up on me because I'm telling you, I am slow. I really am. So I go 3580 put, and we go Control V for vitamin. Paste that in. The dude that come up with this spreadsheet, me, has even put in that. It tells us the delta to sell, and most of the time we behave. So we change that to, we sold a 15 delta. Where did we do it? Well, we did it at 44 days. We did it on St. Patrick's Day. So we did it for what amount? We did it for 25.50. And you know he's going to be upset that he's down already $4.19. And then he's going to go and he's going to look at the weekly premium tab and he's going to make sure that he got credit for that he sold. Huh? Then he's going to go up here and he's going to look and he's going to see how much more he's got left to sell today, knowing that he's got an SPX trade to do at the end of the day and he's still got a Cameron Skinner trade to do. Huh? So I'll get some of that out. He's going to go look over here to admire his handiwork, see how he's doing so far, and he's going to notice everything's looking fine. And that's the game. That's the game we play. Ain't it sweet? And we do it day in, day out. So hopefully, even though you know what I'm going to do, day here and you go, okay, it's there. But is that enough? $3? We'll go back to negative Vega. That's why, because we're going to go hide positions, and we're going to go 1.10 deltas, right? And now a little positive delta to our camp. Well, I'm negative deltas anyway, so I really don't care. I'm pretty much flat. So this is telling me, hey, heck yeah, you could bring this in. Now, if you want to bring in everything, hide positions, you can go show all. And then portfolio beta weighted, right? And then to double check everything, just do this. Go down. And then unclick silver. So right now, it was saying that my delta, I'm gonna make sure all my dates are changed where they need to be. Today's the 7th, it is the 17th, isn't it? And today's the 17th, right? So it says right now with that in there, my delta's negative 13. What is it if I take silver out? Without silver, it's like I'm almost the same, right? It's not having much effect. Okay, it's negative 13.43. What about if I click silver? Then I'm negative 10. So it's adding a couple of positive deltas to that, right? And it's adding a little bit to my theta, it's adding a little bit. So you can take this off easily and you can see whether or not, you know, it makes sense. So if I add silver, will my Vega still be positive? Yeah, I still got great theta and my delta is still negative, not as negative as it was. So I look at this trade and I go, huh, that ain't too bad. Let's route it for 54. Right click, I said, confirm and send, and we'll bring us in $53. And we feel? Are we feel? Well, it doesn't show a working order, does it? What happened to it? Well, anyway, you get the gist, right? Silver, field order. Okay, something field, something clicked here. What is wrong with the Thinkorswim? Did it get canceled? Slow on me. So I'll change that to 53 cents. See if we can bring 53 bucks. Yeah, I got all right, so I'll go in and record that trade so y'all won't have to watch. But a lot of difference together. I mean, you know the trades are. But man, has a lot of work going on behind the scenes. Not only by me, but by people by like Cameron Skinner, by people, you know, who the early retirement now guys. The other thing, again, I have no original ideas in my head, but I have tried just about every one. And if you open that document of that trading plan that has 70-something pages on it, you see Sweet Bobby has tried a lot of things, right? And still some that I'll whoop out every now and then. But on a day-to-day basis, we'll do the same thing over, over, over. And you get out of that having to trade the latest meme stock. You get out of worrying about what everyone else wants to trade. And you start going, I got a few little tickers here that are part of my forest. That's kind of like when we started raising animals, you know. And by the way, I got kicked out of a Facebook group this week. I got kicked out because I was posting on there, you know, what do you do in your local community when people want to buy your eggs for $12 a dozen? But yet you've bought the most quality chicken that you can get, right? I mean, I paid over $50 a piece for my chicks. And I've had people laugh at me and to make fun of me because I wanted a quality chick that produced a quality egg. Right? And so they're like, you know, they laugh at me. And I'm like, yeah, okay. And so now, you know, people in the community want to buy my eggs for $12 a dozen. And I'm like, no, my eggs are $60 a dozen. And then people start, you know, throwing off on you. And I wouldn't pay that for those eggs. Anyway, I got thrown out of a chicken group on Facebook. It's one of the proudest moments of my life, actually. But what I told Beth is I wanted quality, right? Anybody, any Joe Blow can go down to the tractor supply and buy a $2 chick, right? Anybody can do that. Now, was it a good investment by buying a 50-something dollar chick? I don't know. But I do know there's a market for those eggs. And, you know, you got people, someone in New Jersey said, hey, I go through Georgia quite a bit. I'll pay you $60 for a dozen of your eggs. And I'm like, yeah, okay. Let me know the next time you're here and I'll do it. Or I can ship them to you, right? And then you start realizing there's people out there that will pay $60 for a dozen eggs. It's quality. I didn't go for quantity. I didn't say I want the cheapest chicken that'll lay any freaking egg. I got the chicken that provides eggs for the Queen of freaking England, y'all. That's the kind of chicken I got because it produces the darkest egg, the most beautiful egg. And I wanted quality, not quantity. And Beth cooked some the other day. It was so neat. We had some store-bought eggs, right? They all come out of a chicken's butt or whatever they come out of. Hey, Granny. Daddy's in class. I'll be out in a minute. And we compared the look of the commercial egg with the look of the yolk of, you know, the farm fresh egg where we don't feed the chickens anything, really. Every now and then we'll throw them out a little scratch. But you know what the chickens eat? Whatever they find. Because they're in a big old pasture with a big old fence. And they just run out every day when they want to. They go back to their little house when they want to and don't nothing bother. And you can tell the difference in the eggs. Y'all, I'm telling you, they're beautiful. Dark, yolk, rich. God only knows they don't have a hormone in them. Not that I'm saying hormones are bad or whatever they put in the stuff. But if you've ever been in the chicken house business, and I've not, but I used to pick up dead chickens out of chicken houses when I was a kid. You start realizing that they take a chick, you know, from 3 days old, you know, here it is. And the next thing you know, that thing is a full grown chicken that can barely walk in a month or 6 weeks, right? And you go, something ain't right with that. What did they do to that chicken? So no, I'm not going to sell my eggs for $12 a dozen because these animals are treated better. I mean, the best eggs on the planet. So when we got goats, I didn't say, well, let's just go to the flea market and let's just get the first goat that we see. Someone gave us a goat, and it was the first goat that we saw. But now guess what we're doing? We're buying Nigerian dwarf goats. Registered Nigerian dwarf goats. Quality. Now, that doesn't mean that they're better than just an average overdose goat at the trade day, right? But we're trying to get quality. So then when we get pigs, someone says, hey, we got a couple hogs you don't want. No, I don't want just a regular old hog. Not to sound snooty, but I want to do research on hogs. So we did research on hogs to try to eat, right? And so I can't eat them. So of hogs, and then all of a sudden someone's like, you're paying that hog. Little. So I want quality. DNA, I want to know where they come from, right? And so guess what? DNA and the whole nine yards, same thing with my goats. I want them to matters to you. I want quality. So as you're sitting there and you go, I'm going to go to Wall Street Bets today on Reddit, and I'm going to find out what the amateurs are trading. Can I call them amateurs? I won't hurt their feelings. But the memers, the tendies, you know, do I want to trade what they're trading? Heck no. Right? I want to trade the same thing every day, and to do it in a method to where we methodically and mechanically and over and over do the same exact thing every day. And we'll see who wins at the end. All right? Great session today. I appreciate all of you being with me. Ken, Dimitri, Drew, Matt, Rick. And if y'all have any questions whatsoever, let me know. So we got five things in the chat. Make sure I haven't missed anything. Oh, my goodness. I hadn't said anything. Let's see what we got here. Matt, all of his age has an advantage few ever get. I and many like me paid over $100,000. Yes, preach it, Jesus. To leave how to be humble and to get where I am now. To learn how to be humble and to get where I am now. Ken, you are exactly right. You are exactly right. So, Matt, you may be the youngest of the group, but, dude, you are well ahead of the rest of us. Trust me. The real age. Never think, oh, man, I'll never be that. Oh, yes, yeah. Looking to get my first Corvette, I just can't ungrasp me, my fist holding the loot. Dude, that sounds like me. I want me like a 1957 Chevy, but I'm not going to get it till my kids are all out in college and the youngest one is four. Y'all hear her in the background over there putting on makeup. Matt, I've actually worked a few days for the school directing traffic for the district basketball games. $30 to $40 days for 3 days, all going into the trading account. That makes me want to cry. That is beautiful. Hey, Matt, what are you doing down there, man? You getting a little extra money to go to Applebee's tonight? No, Matt's over there, and he's getting $30 to $40 a day for 3 days, all going into his trading account. Y'all see how committed that is? Y'all see how committed that is? And that makes me ashamed I'm not doing more, right, to get more into my trading account. That's beautiful. That is just awesome. What variety of chicken is it? It's a black copper Marans. And I don't care. There's some of them out there that'll say it's Marans, but I don't care. I don't even know how to pronounce it. It's a black copper Marans. That's Marans. That's what I call them. And the cloaca is where the eggs come out. I never want to hear that word again, Ken. Ken, I hope that's the last time I hear cloaca or cloaca or whatever that is. Yeah, I don't even think about that. But yeah, they're black copper Marans. And apparently, I read that. You know how you read stuff. They say that the Queen of England, that's the chicken that provides eggs for the palace. I don't know if that's true. It's just kind of a neat little story anyway, right? Who knows? They may go to the Piggly Wiggly and get the eggs for the palace. I got no idea. And the breed of pig that we're raising is the Cooney Cooney. I don't even know if I'm pronouncing that right. Cooney Cooney. But apparently they don't root a lot, which is so cool, right? Because they're not going to tear my pasture up. Now, God is my witness. As soon as I put them in my pasture, y'all know what they're going to do. As soon as I put on a trade, what does it do? It goes against me, right? Every trade I put on goes against me. So same be my pigs. They'll probably turn on me. Y'all find me one day probably dead in a hog pen being mauled by, 12 Cooney Cooney piglets who thought that I was their mama and was trying to suck milk from them, right? So, good. We got all the chat taken care of. So, great, great session today. And I am honored that y'all come in here every day because I'm going to tell you something. Most people wouldn't do what you are doing. And y'all do it every day. Just about all of y'all are here every day. And I really, really appreciate it. And I really hope that you're getting something out of it. And I'll see y'all tomorrow.